हाय एवरीवन, दिस इज द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ केमिकल काइनेटिक चैप्टर। सो वी इन द लास्ट पार्ट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द चैप्टर केमिकल काइनेटिक्स इंट्रोडक्शन। व्हाट इज केमिकल काइनेटिक्स? सो केमिकल काइनेटिक्स इज अ ब्रांच ऑफ केमिस्ट्री व्हिच डील्स विद द स्टडी ऑफ रेट ऑफ केमिकल रिएक्शंस एंड द फैक्टर्स दैट अफेक्ट द रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन। Then we have studied what is rate of reaction. So we have studied two rate of reaction, average rate of reaction. So average rate of reaction is change in concentration of species upon change in time. Here species can be a reactant or product. So rate of reaction can be a decrease in concentration of reactant per unit time or increase in concentration of product per unit time. What is the unit of rate of reaction? Mole per dm cube, second inverse, or we can write it as a molar second inverse, because shortcut of mole per dm cube is this molar. It represents molarity. Okay. After that, we have studied instantaneous rate. What is instantaneous rate? The change in concentration in a very small interval of time. So only change is what? Here we have used the minus delta. Here it is replaced with minus D for reactant, and for product it is plus D. And the time interval is dt, where in average what is that? Delta. So it is a definite time interval. It is a small, very small time interval. Okay. So in a very small time interval, there will be a small change in concentrations. Then we have seen the in general, if there is a reaction, then how to write a rate of overall reaction in terms. If there are some coefficients are also given, or stoichiometric coefficients with are given with reactant and products, then just take it as a 1 by whatever coefficients are given in terms. So this is a reaction. Here coefficient of reactant A is A. So rate of reaction in terms of this reactant A will be minus 1 by A, concentration change in reactant A. Okay. Let's see rate of reaction and rate reaction concentration. So we have seen some of the problems also based on these rate of reaction. Now we will move further. So what is our next subtopic is rate of reaction and reaction concentration. So there is a term which relates the rate of reaction with reactant concentration. The term is called rate law or rate equation or rate expression. Okay. So rate of reaction at a given temperature for a given instant depends on concentration of reactant, and such a relation is called rate law. So for a general reaction, rate of reaction can be proportional to concentration of A and concentration of B with the power X for reactant A and the power Y with reactant B. Always remember these powers X and Y are experimentally determined. It is not equal to coefficients of reactant A and coefficient of reactant B. Okay. Two important point about this rate law. Rate law is always related to reactants, not with product. And second thing, these powers X and Y are not depends on the coefficients a and b. It is experimentally determined. To remove this proportionality sign, we have used constant K. This constant K is called rate constant, which is independent of concentration and varies with temperature. So in this rate law is also called as differential rate law. It is mentioned power X and Y in the rate law not necessarily equal to stoichiometric coefficient. They may be equal to sometimes, but always they are not equal to these stoichiometric coefficients. And these powers X and Y can be a whole number, zero or fraction. Okay, let's see the cases given. For x y equal to 1, rate is this x and y becomes one. So equation implies that the rate of reaction depends linearly on concentration of A and B. As the power is one, that's why they say linearly. If either of concentration is double, if concentration of A is double and concentration of B is kept constant, then rate of reaction will increase two times. If both the concentration are double, then overall rate will be increased four times. Okay. In the second, x is equal to 2, power of A is 2 and power of B is 1. So if concentration of A is doubled, so the here is power 2, so it doubled means 2A, the overall rate reaction will increase 4 times if B is constant. Okay. Or let us consider it power of both concentration of A and B is increased 2 times or both concentration gets double, then what will be the new rate of reaction? How much it will increase? The power of A is doubled. So we will write here 2A. So 2A, as we have to square it, so overall will become as a 4, and for B, 2B. Okay, so this B will multiply it with 4. Overall rate of reaction will increase 6 times. Okay, hope you have understood what I'm saying. If concentration of A is increased 2 times, so here is power 2, so that 2 will become 4, and concentration of B is also increased 2 times, so here the coefficient comes 2, this 2 multiplied with the 4, it becomes 4 into 2, 8, so rate of reaction will increase 8 times. Sorry, I already mentioned 6 times, so what is, how much rate of reaction will increase? 8 times. We will see the problem and we'll understand clearly. So if x equal to 0, rate is independent of concentration of A. Such a reaction is called a zero order reaction. Okay, if the rate of reaction does not depend on the concentration of reactant, then such a reaction is called as a zero order reaction. If x is less than 0, rate decreases as concentration of A increases. If x is less than 0, what does it mean? The power of concentration A is minus x, or it will be 1 upon rate equal to what will be then? Rate equal to 1 by concentration of A, as power is minus x, so it will come as a this plus x. Okay, so if the concentration of A will increase, then the rate will decrease. So that is written. If concentration of A increases, rate decreases. This x is less than 0 means power of A is minus x. So that's why I written as a 1 by concentration of A with the power x. Okay, hope you understand. So how the rate law is written? For example, given this is a reaction, for this reaction rate is proportional to concentration of H2O2. So directly write rate equal to K. These square brackets represents, always remember these square brackets represent concentration. So concentration of H2O2, it is written with the power 1. Okay, so it is directly written proportional to. For this, try this, is experimentally found that proportional to square of concentration of NO2 and independent of CO. So how will we write rate? The rate will be equal to K concentration of this NO2. You will write here NO2. Okay. And what is it is square of. So write down power, and it is dependent or independent of this reactant. So no need to write this. Okay. Independent means no need to write. Or you can write as a concentration of CO multiplied with above and write down the power as a 0. As we know that power of anything is 0, then what will be the answer? 1. Okay, so rate will be equal to K concentration of NO2 whole power, what is the power? 2. Okay. Let's see the another problem, 6.2. So problem 6.2 such type problems come in exam for 3 marks. Similar to this problem, we have unsolved problem. We will see that and we will understand how it is solved. Okay, so this is the whole subtopic about rate equation or rate law, rate expression. So let's see the problem related to, we will understand this solved problem by solving the unsolved problem. Or if you want to understand, let's see. So this is a table. In the table, in the first column, concentration of A is given. In the second column, concentration of B is given and related rate of reaction given. So this is the equation is given, chemical equation. So we have to find out the rate law, rate expression. So let us consider, mostly try to solve. There are two methods explained. So this is a word method. You have to explain by word or just explain by calculation. So always try this method. This is a good method and it is can be understood. Okay. So in this method, we have a given reaction A plus B that gives product P. So we have to, let us consider rate law as a K. Rate equal to K. We don't know the power X and Y. So keep in a general X one that we have to find out. Okay. So from the table, what is given? I hope you can see. Okay. So we have assumed rate is equal to K with concentration A with power X, concentration B with power Y in terms of rate expression. So from first data, what is, let us take what is the rate 4 into 10 to minus 5. So written that what is concentration of A is 0.4. So use that, concentration of B is 0.2. So written that value. I think it is not written K, so write down K also. It missed, or it is a printing mistake. So K is there, so write K here also. And from the second data, what is rate 6.0? So what is the rate 6.6 into 10 to minus 5. So written then what is concentration of A, concentration B. It was just written that, and let's divide as they, both the terms I am K and K will be constant, and dividing these two equations, then K gets cancelled. What we are getting as a power 1.5x, and here the answer is on dividing these two equations, you are getting 1.5. So as base is same, the power will be also equal, so x equal to 1. Similarly, we have taken first two, let's take third one also. So this first is all again used here. For the third one, what is the rate 3.2 10 to minus 4 and concentration of A, concentration B is given. Okay, so put here and just divide those, you can get the value of Y in the similar, in this way you can get the X or Y value. Okay. Similarly, there is another problem. Okay, so this problem is not similar. This problem, try this is same. So in this problem, what is given? You have given a chemical equation. Rate law is already given. If the rate of reaction is given, and concentration of NOBR is also given, and we have to find out rate constant. So by rate law, we have given this rate. This concentration, you have to find only K. So it is simple. Just divide rate by this and put the values. So this problem comes for 2 marks and the above problem is come for 3 marks. Let's move ahead. We have to try this. So I have solved this problem. So in the problem, it is similar to this problem. So the equation is given 2a plus 2b, 2a plus 2b, 2c plus d. I have solved this problem here. And what is written? Concentration of A is double at constant B, and the rate increases by a factor of 4. Okay, if the concentration of B is double, so from first case, what is written? Concentration of A is double at constant B, and the rate increases by a factor of 4. In the second case, what is given? B is double and A is kept constant. A is kept constant, then also rate is double. Okay, so write the rate law. So whenever we have given such conditions, or in this problem a table is given, and in this problem the condition is given inward met. So whenever you have to find out rate law from given condition, so just assume rate equal to k, concentration of A. So rate law rate depends on concentration of reactant. So written concentration of A and concentration of B with power x and y. Okay. Okay, so from first case, we have considered the new rate as a rate 2. So concentration of A is doubled, so written A as a 2A, and B is constant, so no change. Okay, so let's divide rate 2 by rate 1. As rate increases by a factor of 4, so if we divide rate 2 by rate 1, we will get as a factor 4, or we can say that rate 2 is 4 times the initial rate 1. So what is rate 2? Just write down this equation. What is rate 1? Just write down this equation. This gets cancelled. Okay. Okay. This whole gets cancelled. And this KK gets cancelled. A gets cancelled. 2x by 1x will as a 2x. So 4. So 4 can be write as 2 raised to 2. We will get x equal to 2. Okay. Let's see the next. In next condition, what is written? B's concentration is double and A is kept constant. So we have considered the new rate as rate 3. So rate 3 is a double. Rate gets double after keeping B's concentration increased by 2 times and A is keeping as a constant. So what is rate 3? Just put this value. And what is rate 1? Put these values. Again, solve like above. You will this b be cancelled, 2 raised to y and 1 raised to y. Anything raised to 1 is always 1. So 2y equal to 2, then you will get y is equal to 1. So you will get x equal to 2. Put here, you will get the rate law. Okay. In this problem, what is other things is asked? If the rate constant is given, what is the rate of reaction when A is concentration and B is reaction? So you have find out the rate as here after putting X and Y values. So K is value given, concentration of A is given, concentration of B is given. We have to find out rate. So just put the value and get the answer. This mole DMQ per DMQ can be written as a molar, capital M. This is a shortcut to write this mole per DMQ, or it is a molarity, that's why. Okay, in this way we have solved this problem. Okay, so we have covered the solved problems of this subtopic. Let's see some of the solved problems of some of the unsolved problems. Okay, let me a single page view. So in solved, unsolved, we have given first this problem. For the reaction, what is the relation between this concentration? So in earlier topic, we have seen all these things. First topic. So the rate in terms of reactants and product reaction, how to write in our first topic. We have remembered the rate. So written the reaction. So rate equal to the coefficient of N2 is 1. Then as a in reactants concentration is decreasing, so we will use the sign minus. Coefficient of N2 is a minus 1 by 1 and coefficient of s2 will be minus 1 by 3 and that of product is plus 1 by 2. Okay, so how we have write these coefficients, we use this coefficient to write down the rate of reaction from the first subtopic we have read. Let me show what formula I used. So I have used okay, 131 is the place. So I have used this formula. So this is a general formula is given in terms of coefficients with reactant A and B. So how we have to write down the rate. So in by using this formula, I have written the rate. Okay. So we have find out the relation between all these concentration terms as it is mentioned in the problem. Okay. So we have covered this problem. So just highlight this. Okay, you have to just find out what is the relation. So this rate gives the relation between all these terms. Okay, let's move to the next problem. For this reaction, if this is the reaction given, rate law is also given. Okay, rate law is given. We write in the rate law is given. What is the first case? How does reaction rate changes if concentration of OH minus is decreased by a factor of 5? So if you decrease the factor of 5, then we have written OH minus by 5. The overall rate decreases by factor of 5. And what is the second condition? Concentration of both the reactants are doubled. So written doubled means CH3Br will be written as a 2 times and OH minus also written as a 2 times. So see, these 2 into 2 will be 4. So rate of reaction will increase 4 times. Okay. I hope you understand this problem. Let's move to the next problem. Wait, there is a MCQ also on based on the topic we have covered. So this is a MCQ. Rate law is given as a rate equal to KAB. Rate of reaction doubles if conditions are given. So I have written this equation. Rate original rate is given. Rate zero, rate original. Okay. So from first option, concentration of A and B are both double. For increasing the rate as a 2 times. Okay. So if we increase the concentration of A constant 2 times, so we written A as a 2, rate, overall rate will increase by 4 times. So this is not a correct answer. For second case, A is double and B is kept constant. So A is double and B is kept constant. So overall rate increases by 2 times. That's we want. Rate of reaction doubles if condition B is a correct answer. Let's say condition C or D also, B is double, so increases B 2 times and A is half. So this A 2 get cancelled, we will get the same rate. For condition D, concentration of B is half and A is kept constant, so rate will, new rate will be getting as a half of original rate. So answer B is correct, C and D are wrong. I have shown how they are wrong. Okay. Let's move to the unsolved problem of today's subtopic. Here, this one. Let's highlight, we will solve this problem. Okay. So similar problem we have discussed in our solved. You have given a table, you have to find out rate law. So assume the rate as a rate equal to K. Concentration of with power x, concentration with the power y. From the first condition, what is rate? 0.15. Concentration of is 0.3. Okay, concentration of b is 0.05. So written that. From the second case, rate is 0.30. Concentration of a and b are 0.6. So written that. In similar way, third is also written using third data. Okay. Rate is 1.20. Concentration of A and concentration B is given as 0.6.2. Okay. So let's divide equation, this equation 2 by 1. Okay, 0.30 by 0.15, divide this whole by this one. This gets cancelled. 0.6 by 0.3, as the power is same, we can combine as a 0.6 by 0.3. We will get the as a dividing, we'll get 2. 0.30 by 0.15, we'll get 2. Some of the students confused about how these two come. So first step is to emit this decimal, multiply by 100 up and down, numerator and denominator, you will get the 2. Okay, if we have divided 2 by 1, let's divide 3 by 1. Divide in a such way such that some of the variable term gets cancelled. So here in divide 2 by 1, we are saying these are same. So this 2 will be gets cancelled. On dividing third by 2, we are seeing as 0.6 is same. So it gets cancelled, we will get y. So always remember this logic. So divide third by 1 in the same way. This gets cancelled whole. You have 0.2 by 0.005. So it will come as a 4. Here also 4. So y is equal to 1. X here y 1. So put in our original. Okay. Original rate, x and y value, you will get a rate laws. Okay, in this way we have solved this unsolved problems. Okay, so for today's lecture that is that much only. So we have seen the rate of reaction in terms of reactant concentration and product concentration, how to write down. Then we have seen the relation between the rate and concentration of reactant by today's topic. In next lecture, we will move ahead and see the other topics also. So other topic is what? Let's see. So other topic may be order of reaction. So this is also simple time. Order of reaction is nothing but the addition of these powers, some x plus y. We will see in the next lecture. Thank you.